Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika and in this video we are going to create Saturn's rings. This artwork is inspired by a very famous poster for London Underground made by Man Ray. And a lot of other artworks have been created inspired by it already. So let's just take a look at how to do this in Illustrator using 3D effects. So what we want to do is have Saturn's rings going round the moon. And they should be in rainbow colors. I have already prepared some base artwork for that. Of course, in order to create that, we need to use the Revolve effect, and the base artwork for it will be a circle that we need to divide in half, and then, of course, all those rectangles for the rings. And we want to have them revolve around the moon. And I have this photo of the moon that I have taken a few years back. And you can use that, of course, for it. And you can use any photo of any round object for this. In the case of the moon, of course, you can use other images as well. And NASA has provided that kind of images for us to use, and I'm going to show you this. It's these kinds of images. They have these CGI maps for the moon, and they are also there for the Earth, which we could use. This is an image of the moon that matches the kind of projection you need for Illustrator. In order to use that, what you have to do is, after placing it, of course, you need to embed it and then open the symbols panel and drag that photo in it, and that's it. You name it and then OK. So let's take a look at this. Now, the first thing we need to do is, of course, make this into a half circle. I'm just selecting this point with the direct selection tool and delete it. And then I'm going to color this in black and then group all of these. So going to object and group. That's it. And now what we need to do is, using effect, 3D and materials, and the classic effect revolve. And of course, we need to do this from the right edge, and there it is. That's what we need. Just rotate this slightly and this looks okay. So the two methods now, I could map the art, and I'm going to cycle through them. So this is the circle, and just select the moon, scale to fit, and there we would have it. That is easy. So that's what you need to do if you use the NASA images. But I'm going to set this to none because I want to take a look at the other method. And then we need to do, of course, the lighting. And for this other method, it would be best if the reflection is not there. That's easier. Of course, you can use it, but it's easier if it's not there. So we're going to diffuse shading, and then let's have some lighting on this. So this gets really bright. That's nice. And then we can reduce the blend steps, but we don't need to, so that's okay as well. There's another video about how to improve the output if you want to later apply gradients, but in this case, so we'll leave it as it is and go to OK. So that's the base artwork. And in this case, I'm going to make a copy of it. We actually need to expand that and go to Object and expand the appearance. That's it. And then we need to take a look at it. And you see there's just one shape here. We don't need the bottom one, so let's get rid of it. There are some more of this. That's it. And then this one, this top one, let's take a look at it in here. And there we have it. So these two are the ones we need. I'm selecting them both, and then let's cut them and paste them in front. At this point, we have to check their color. So let's open the color panel. And you have to make sure that they are black. These are 100%, which is okay, but you can also apply the registration color, and in RGB it needs to be 000. And then we can proceed. And now I'm going to group them, select all, and now let's go to the transparency panel and make a mask. And uncheck clip. And now what we can do is put this over the photo so that it matches like so. And that's the method to apply this to any photo. So there you have two methods. The links to the NASA images are in the comments, and have fun creating this. If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.